Today, this is the first Gita class after 2-3 months, I think. I am taking this class. Who was taking? You were taking? Okay. So, I express my gratitude to you.
Thank you.
And by filling up the gap, you know. Today, I want to share with you a very subtle thought. Kim tad brahma, kim adhyatmam, kim karma purushottam, adibhutam cha kim proktam, adidevam kim uchate. Arjuna is asking 5 questions in this particular verse. Usually, Bhagavad Gita is a dialogue between man and God. Usually there is one question and one answer. But he is so much obsessed with the benevolence, wisdom of Lord Krishna. He wants to squeeze every iota of knowledge from Lord Krishna. So he is asking many, many questions. And in this particular verse, he has 5 questions. Kim tad brahma? Brahma kya hai? अध्यात्म क्या है? किम तद् ब्रह्म, किम अध्यात्मम, किम कर्म, व्हाट इज एक्शन, कर्मा, देन अधिभूत क्या है और अधिदेव क्या है? दीज आर द 5 क्वेश्चंस. सो वी विल टेक वन एट अ टाइम. लॉर्ड कृष्णा सेज इन देयर आर लॉट ऑफ थियरीज फ्लोटिंग अराउंड बट वी आर concentrating and focusing on one element, and that is Bhagavad Gita. What the Bhagavad Gita, the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita says about these things. Bhagavad Gita says that Brahm, anything which is visible, Aksharam Brahma, jo aapko aankh se dikhai deta hai, whatever you can see with your naked eyes, that is Brahm. Broadly speaking, general definition, generic definition. Whatever you see with your naked eye, it is Brahm. But then Gita goes beyond that. So let us stay with this element and then I will touch the other one. What is visible? Billions of galaxies, trillions of stars, nebulas, space, ecology, people like you and me, 7.3 billion people on this tiny earth, which is hanging with the gravitational force, floating around. Ecology, if you see the sea world, there are more creatures than the human beings. Look at the forests, trees, they're so symmetrical. There's no land mower coming there or cutting the branches or making the shapes. No. But there are billions of trees, animals. Look at the beauty. Each animal, birds, such a divine color combinations. So this huge, humongous display of the creation, this is called Brahm. But then the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita penetrates further. It says that manifested creation is the extension of unmanifested Sakar Niraka. So whatever you see, there is a force behind that. Otherwise it cannot sustain. It cannot. And according to Hindu Vedic thought, the Trinity, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Brahma is the creator. Vishnu, that entity sustains. And then Lord Shiva, He takes care of for the new creation. Dissolve it and hand it over to Brahma. It's a cycle. It's a cycle. But having said that, what is for me? Why should I know this? Why should I know it? Theory, it looks very good. It's all right. But what is for me? For us, the idea of Bhagavad Gita is that respect the creation. Respect the creation. Since we could not, cannot, and will never ever be able to create anything, so whatever has been created, respect it, adore it, worship it. And more than that, since we are social animals, we live in societies, we live in groups, you call it a family, you call it a social cycle, villages, districts, states, countries, world. So we are connected. We are connected. 7.3 billion people, does not matter whether the guy is Chinese, Russian, European, Indian, Pakistan, any country and all the countries. If you are the student of Bhagavad Gita, you got to respect everybody. Otherwise, you are missing the message. So, respecting the creation as it is, plants, respect them. Animals, respect them. People, irrespective of national origin, language, geographical location, what language they speak, tall, small, fat, white, brown, does not matter. It is a color combination. So respect the creation. And since we are not doing that, look at the condition this planet is facing. And Bhagavad Gita said that thousands and thousands years before, they do like this. Now the science has jumped in. The Western world, they are very serious now. And they are coming up. They are allocated billions of dollars of resources. Don't pollute the environment. Don't pollute the oceans. Don't pollute the vegetation. Because otherwise it will come back to you and you will pay the heavy price. But we have been doing that. Now the damage is done. We are trying to contain it. And it takes time. But the idea is, as of today, when we are sitting here, I have to commit myself. If you want a change, we have to change. Change have to start. Start with me. We give to the society what we have. If I don't have, I cannot. I cannot. So whatever you want other people to do, start doing yourself. Start doing yourself. This is, I'm just talking of Brahma, the creation. Look at the fabric of family life. When we don't respect the creation. Husband and wife. I have been stressing this in many, many presentations. Living together for 30, 40 years. Sleeping on the same bed. Producing children. Eating the same food. All the resources are joined. But still they are fighting. They didn't get it right. So, the idea is Brahm, which means you got to respect the divinity, like we say namaste, right? What does that mean? That is a message coming out of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, that I respect the divinity in you and I bow my head and heart when I say namaste. That is the respect. And in Hindu tradition, we have been doing that. Intentionally, unintentionally. But that's a good thing. But we didn't go beyond that. We get married. He or she, both are partners. So try to look the divinity in the eyes of your wife. And vice versa. Relationships will be very spiritual, very cordial, very permanent if you do that. Most of the self-inflicted miseries, they will be evaporated. Children, brothers, sisters, the family life is totally shattered only due to this, that we forgot. We forgot that I have to look the divinity in others. There are two ways to live in this world. One is to look the positivity in others, merits. I meet you, you greet me. I should focus myself in your merits, not demerits. So let us say, you are my best friend. We say, everybody has best friend. So what are we doing? We are focusing on that individual's merits. Our whole focus is on their merits. And then, after 1 year, you change your mind and you start looking demerits in the same individual. And then you say, I don't like you. I don't like you. So that person, that entity becomes your enemy. And this is what has happened to the family life. First sight love. When we got married, what we did? You were in the office. She was home. You were connected. Connected. Everybody has that experience. Everybody. But now what has happened? At that time, we were looking the merits of each other. We intentionally, unintentionally, let it go, the demerits. But after 5 years, 2 years, depending upon your resistance, we start looking the demerits. Tumne ye nahi kiya, tumne ye nahi kiya. Maine ye kaha tha, tumne ye kaha tha. No. Nothing has gone wrong. Both individuals are same. So the idea is, if we want to respect the creation, charity begins at home. Home. And in English, Shakespeare said that very clearly. Man's kingdom is his own. So if I don't behave kingly way in my own kingdom, I am missing the point. That is my kingdom. My home is my kingdom. So I have to stop. That this is what Bhagavad Gita is. That is why I said that I gave you the definition of Brahma. But what is for me? This is for me. This is for me. Then I have, commit yourself right now, that I will focus on the merits of my wife. And wife should do the same. This circle will be reversed. Your friends, society will be better. But we are not doing that. We are not doing that, and we are paying very heavy price. So if you want to make the family life better, society better, then focus on the merits of others. Merits of others. When you do that, it has the extension. Like it has the extension. I am holding this, but it has the extension. The extension is, the more you are focusing on the merits of others, the more you are positive. It is a litmus test. Positivity is the other name of spirituality. People who are spiritual, they are 100% positive. And people who are 100% positive, they are positive only because they have developed the technique, practice, and made it perfect to look the merits of others. So, stay, look, the focus on the merits of others. That will make you positive. And positive, I said, it's a litmus test of spirituality. How much positive you are, that will speak of how much spiritual you are. Look at these gifted souls, Mahatmas, saints, who has reached that level. Does not matter what dress you wear. You could be naked, you wear brown, saffron. Outer appearance does not matter. People who are positive, who are spiritual, their dress does not matter. Matter is, are they making people positive whenever they interact with the society? Or are they making them negative? So when Mahatma, gifted soul, comes to your home, what happens? What happens? Have you ever evaluated what he says? Every word is positive. He will praise you. Beta, aap bade acche ho. He may be meeting you first time. But when we meet somebody first time, you immediately make a mental image. They say, first impression. Who are you to make the first impression? We should not judge people. First of all, judge yourself. When the mirror is clean, you are beautiful. Which means when your thinking is clean, when you know how to think, that will make you a brighter, better, productive, qualitative individual. You can change the society. Wherever you will go, the moment you will speak, you will infuse the people with positivity. And when they will leave, they will be thinking 100 times that this was a good interaction. So this is the beauty. Brahma, respect the creation and start from home. Start from home. Make the home your kingdom and behave like a king. And give the promotive attitude to your wife. Let her be a queen. So, we said enough now about Brahma. The same way, we should respect the trees. We should respect the waters. We should respect the airways. We should respect the fire. You know how to respect the fire? What does it mean, respect the fire? Agni Devta, hum kehte hain. What does it mean, Devta? Devta means who gives you. Who gives you. So how to respect the fire? How to respect the air? Respect the fire means fire is inside you. When the fire goes away, everybody is dead. Fire is inside. So when the fire is inside, when you want to, let us say, ignite fire here, what do you need? If you want to make a fire here, what do you need?
Matchbox.
Matchbox, right? At least matchbox or what you call that?
Some wood.
Yeah. And some material, wood, it could be anything, right? So the fire which is inside us, you ignite with your food. So watch what type of fire you want. You want to be qualitative? Eat qualitative. You are what you eat. Bhagavad Gita said 1,000 years before, but European writers start saying that in English because we have a slave mentality. When anything is said in English, we think our rishis, munis were idiots. No, they borrowed these ideas. They stole those ideas, that heritage. We should be proud of. So, we are what we eat. Pure. So, when you put something in your mouth, be extremely careful. This is not a dumping ground. It is not a dumping ground. God has created this beautiful body. Look at the intricacy. A little thing goes wrong with your body. There are 20-story building which is called hospital to correct that. Can you imagine that? And all your vital organs are fit in 7 by 8 inch. So if so much, that is the climax of engineering, genius, we should respect that. We should respect that. So in order to make the proper use, not misuse or abuse the fire, we misuse and abuse the fire, you know, by eating wrong things. By eating wrong things. Jaise aapki lakdi hai, aapne gili laga di hai. The wood is wet. To aap usko matchbox se jala rahe ho. What happens? What happens? Smoke? Smoke? It doesn't mean anything does not happen. It happens. It produces smoke, not fire. So when our body needs fire, but we are producing smoke, we are sick. We are sick with various ailments, diseases. But it is in our hands. Spirituality is responsibility. I cannot blame anybody. With my own two hands, I put things in my mouth. I am not in a jail where I am forced to eat. You go to the supermarket. You have your beautiful home. It depends on you. What should go inside? So, if you want to keep yourself healthy, eat healthy. Eat healthy. It is coming out of the same extension of Brahma. Respect. Respect. Before you respect the others, respect yourself. I am saying that charity begins at home. So make yourself qualitative. And according to Bhagavad Gita, there are three types of foods: sattvic, rajasic, tamasic. Depending on the quality, what you pick up, that will be categorized accordingly. Now, what you want it is your choice. The supermarket, they displayed everything. There is a sattvic food available. There is a rajasic food available. And there is a tamasic food available. You say, give me this. People go to Delhi, right? They have displayed all. Even if they write the calories, still we say, give me this. Because it has a taste. So, who is messing up? Me. You, individually. So, spirituality makes you aware that be responsible. Be responsible. Respect your body. Respect your body. And according to the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, Lord Krishna gave a very revolutionized idea that we are not the bodies, we are living in the bodies. Now this is a beautiful distinction. Now you are two entities. You are living, I am living in this body, but I am not the body. I am the driver, and I am driving a very expensive car. If very expensive car needs the oil change, I take it to the mechanic. And what verbally I say, this car, which is mine, which is very expensive, needs oil change. I am all right. You sit on the sofa and they take the car, change the oil and give it back to you. Do we do that to our bodies? No. We have lost the distinction. We think we are this. If somebody's head is paining, he never says that my body part is having a problem. I am okay. I am okay. But we never say that. We have not practiced that art and we are paying the heavy price. So, remember this, that we are not the bodies, we are living in the bodies. This body, when you, do you, everybody has a car? Is it leased or owned?
Leased.
Everybody has a lease, right? So when you lease the car, and when you sign the lease, right? What is the general commitment? Apart from monthly payment or down payment, whatever the terms are. During the lease term, let us say 3 years, what is your responsibility as a lessor about this car? Normal taking care. You have to take care the car. When it needs oil change, you have to get it oil change. If the pressure is less, you have to get it fixed. Other problems, take to the dealer. I mean, you have to take care of your car. If you don't, if you misuse, abuse, at the end termination of your lease, he will not accept it. You are stuck with it. Am I right? Because you have written that. You have signed that. And it is written in fine prints that it will happen like that. So normal wear and tear is accepted. Normal wear and tear is accepted. But misuse and abuse is not. It is no, no. Exactly the same principle is applicable to our bodies. You have taken a lease from Lord Krishna, this body. And when we die, we are not allowed to take this. We leave it here. We leave it here. So, if you have taken a lease from Lord Krishna and you have to return it. What should be my mode of thinking? I have to take care of. I should eat right, I should exercise, I should jog, I should do certain things that my this stays in shape. This is called spirituality in action, applied. मंदिरों में घंटियां बजा लेना, आरतियां कर लेना, those are rituals. Mandirs are social set up to bring the society together. It has nothing to do with spirituality. Spirituality is your home. Your mandir is your home. If your home is not peaceful, you will never find peace anywhere. So my whole concentration, whole focus of my mind, all my resources should be spent that my home should be a temple. Jo hum mandir mein nahi karte, don't do. This is also a mandir. In chapter 15, Lord Krishna says, sarvasya chaham haridisannivishto mattaha samritir jnanam pohanam cha vedaich sarvai rahmev vedyo vedant krite avidev cha. I am seated in the heart of everybody. This is what this particular verse says. This chapter 15 is Purushottam Yoga Nam. It has the ability and technique and resources and the wisdom to unite you to the Almighty, Divine Forces. If you follow these 20 verses of Srimad Bhagavad Gita in chapter 15. This particular verse which I shared with you, it says, I am seated in the heart of everybody. I am the memory. I am the forgetfulness. अगर मेरी कृपा नहीं होगी तो आप चीज भूलोगे नहीं. और हम आपने देखा है आप चीजें नहीं भूलते. मैंने 20 साल आपके साथ बड़ा अच्छा व्यवहार किया. One day I did something wrong. You immediately delete all my good things and you save that little thing. And we have been doing that. And that's why we suffer. Brother, sister, mother, father, chacha, chachi, kisi ne 10 years before jo kuch bhi kaha. Did you forget? If it was bad, we never forget. If it was good, then maybe a faint memory. Maybe 30%, 70% is still gone. So what it means? It means I am seated in the heart of everybody means I am, your body is a temple. When you say temple, temple mein kya hota hai? This is a classroom, right? If I bring Lord Rama, Lord Hanuman, Lord Krishna, इसको क्लीन करके या मूर्ति स्थापन कर दूं, टुमारो यू विल से माय गॉड दिस इज अ मंदिर. डू इट से ऑर नॉट? डोंट वी? इफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा सेज आई एम सिटिंग इन योर हार्ट दैट मीन योर बॉडी इज अ टेम्पल. Respected. Don't do those things to demolish the temple, to destroy the temple. Respect it, adore it, because your body is a temple. Eat right, Eat right. I call every out of 10, statistically speaking, 6 people are suffering from sugar. Am I right? You ask anybody in any family, in any social gathering, people have problem. People have problem. Who created that? लड्डू मैंने खाए, जलेबी मैंने खाई, किसी ने मेरे मुंह में नहीं डाली, और अभी भी मेरी आई एम टेकिंग द मेडिसिन बट स्टिल व्हेन आई गो टू पार्टी आई मे नॉट बी ईटिंग एट होम बट व्हेन आई एम इन द पार्टी आई एम ए वाइल्ड एनिमल वहां उन्होंने डिस्प्ले किया हुआ है आई डोंट हैव द डिसिप्लिन टू रिजिस्ट द टेम्पटेशन नॉट टू ईट Because I totally forgot that Lord Krishna is here and I am the temple. I am the temple. I should not destroy it. So this is the awareness. Bhagavad Gita class is awareness. It makes you aware that there is a better life to live. Better life to live. There is more experience available. Better, qualitative. And try to get that. So, the second part in that sloka is, I am the memory. I am the memory. It looks very simple, I am the memory. So what? Yes, sir. So what is there? We have been practicing the day we are born, till we die, the art of misusing and abusing our memory. What is misuse and abuse? You put on the TV these days, right? Early morning. Each channel is giving you sermons, one Mahatma after the other. Right? Right? So, Gyan is available at no cost. Google, which is the Mahatma of all the Mahatmas in your palm, right? Does not matter what I say. If you doubt my any presentation, Google it. It will tell you right or wrong, right? So much is available. In, I think, about 50 years back, it was not available. You want to hear some good words, you have to travel 100 miles, 200 miles on the back of the horse or on foot at the top of the hill in the middle of the dense forest. Kutiya mein, unke charno mein baith kar kuch aap sunte the. And whatever we were doing, society was still better. But now, this is my point. The question was memory. Now, look, so much knowledge is available before even you sip your cup of tea at no cost. And look at the deterioration of our lives. Do you think this present time is better, I'm talking spiritually, than our forefathers? My mama, your mama, your grandfather, everybody's grandfather, they were wiser, quieter, peaceful. They also died. We will also die. But they lived. We are suffering. So much struggle. Bachchon ka, apna, job ka, career ka, advancement ka, investment ka. It was not like that. But that is not a pessimistic way of looking at the things. The positivity coming out of it is, we have the option available. We are on the driving seat. I can connect it once I'm aware. If you know red light means I should not drive, don't take a chance. Don't look for the pedestrian. Don't look for the cop. Red light means red light. Stop it. Whether it is in Manhattan or Long Island or in Arizona, where, let us say, 100-mile straight road, and by mistake there is one red light, and I am driving. Now what happens? If I have not practiced, red light means stop. If I have practiced this, I will stop in there also. Otherwise, I will speed up. In our daily lives, we are doing that. We are not practicing the right way. And practice, in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 12, verse 12, Shreyo hi jnanam abhyasa. Jnana dhyanam visheshate dhyanat karma phalatyagasya tyaga chanti nanantara. There is a system. Everything. Spirituality is not a hobby. Spirituality is the top priority of your life. That is the top priority. But we are treating as a hobby. Roti pani kha liya, chalo mandir chale jate hain. Aaj kisi ne bulaya hai, to mandir chale jate hain. No. It does not work that way. And once I am in the mandir and come back, I think I have done great thing. You have done nothing. You have wasted time. You could have meditated at home. Whatever thoughts are being discussed, bring them back. Bring them back. Meditate on that. Focus on that. Otherwise, it's a wastage of time. We let it go. And that is our limitation. That is our limitation. So what I was sharing with you, Lord Krishna says, I am the memory. So remember those things. Save those things which should be remembered and delete the garbage. In computer you do. Everybody is getting 100 emails. How many you say? Two or three. Everything else on a daily basis, I delete. Do we do with our memory? At the end of the day, what should be deleted? What should be saved? No. Roti kha kar hum so jate hain. Computer ka kar dete hain. But we don't do this. We don't do this. Because we take it for granted. Theek ho jayega. Kuch theek nahi hoga. Kuch theek nahi hoga. So, Lord Krishna, if he says, when he says, Lord Krishna means, God is sharing that wisdom. Give that much weight. What is being said? Not an ordinary person is saying. Not a principal, not the prime minister, not the president. The creator, who is the owner, who created this phenomenal tamasha, he is giving the rule. Obey that rule. So, if Lord Krishna is memory, respect the memory. That way you are respecting Lord Krishna. And respecting the memory, how it could be done? Save the merits of others on a daily basis and delete the demerits of others and keep the chip of your memory at an optimum level. Otherwise, nothing will go inside. Because there is no space. Computers tell you. But this is silent. you will start thinking wrong things. Spirituality will become a hobby. It will be a social grabbing. No. So, we started with, how much time we have now? Do we have time?
We can continue until the kids come.
No. I have to go.
Oh, okay.
So, another 5 minutes I will wrap it up. But it's very interesting, we will continue. I shared with you the definition of Brahma. What is Brahma? Brahma means anything visible with your naked eye. That is Brahma. So everything is Brahma. Right? Naked eye does not mean the blind people are not subject to that. No. Naked eye means whatever is surrounding through touch, through taste, to smell. This is all creation. Respect it. Respect it. So, if we do that, and then I said that manifested creation is the extension of unmanifested divine forces, jisko hum Paramatma kehte hain. Nirakar, this is Sakar. So, agar aapne Nirakar ki puja karni hai, तो उसकी जो बनाई हुई चीजें हैं उनकी भी पूजा करो, उनकी भी पूजा करो. वो साकार पूजा है. एक है मूर्ति पूजा, एक है साकार पूजा. आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द मूर्ति पूजा, बट मूर्ति पूजा इज ऑल्सो ए पार्ट ऑफ साकार पूजा. बट साकार पूजा गोज बियॉन्ड दैट. इवन द बटरफ्लाई, रिस्पेक्ट दैट. That is Sakar Puja. हम गाय के लिए रोटी निकालते थे इंडिया में before we eat for birds. Why we do that? This is the thought. Respect. Respect. So, and then we said that Lord Krishna is seated in everybody's heart. So everybody is a temple, moving temple, talking temple, walking temple, everybody. Respect. Respect others, but before that, respect yourself. Ek hota hai abhiman, ek hota hai swabhiman. Abhiman means you are pretending what you are not. Abhiman means, Swabhiman means you are reinforcing, establishing yourself that I am in my heart Lord Krishna, so I am divine. So I will do with that awareness, I will start doing divine things. Then I will stay divine. Otherwise I will become a Satan. So Jai Shri Krishna, we will continue our Bhagavad Gita's wisdom to be shared with all of you. And it's awareness. Stay aware. But don't lose it. Try to reflect it. What we have discussed, try to reflect it in your own way. Everybody has a different state of mind. But this 1,000-mile journey has to start with one step. So take this step. Don't delay it. Thank you. Jai Shri Krishna. I have to go a little earlier.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay.